Yeah, that's the customary one. But how do you call this one? And how do we call it? That's the custom, the al-urf. This is the urf. This is the urf. But how do we call it? What is the meaning in Arabic? Ahsanta, su'alul khayri lil ghayri. Su'alul khayri lil ghayri. Muhammad Dukur is not here, so. Su'alul khayri lil ghayri. This is the intercession that the person asks. Because as we study the ash-shafa'a, it is of three types. You have the lugha, you have the urf, and you have the shari'i, the meaning of the sharia. So therefore he said that وَتُشْفَعَ لِمَنْ اِحْتَاجَ بِالشَّفَاعَةِ, that you are making that which is intercession for the one that is in need of intercession. Meaning, you are asking something good on behalf of someone else. So Rasha Hafidhullah, he say تُبَذِّلُ الْمَعْرُوفِ, that you are putting forth al-ma'roof, meaning goodness, kindness, meaning good actions. He say جَمِيعُ, every single thing. He say وُجُوهُ الْمَعْرُوفِ, all aspects of goodness that you are putting forth to that. He say likewise تُكْرِمُ الضَّيْفِ, you are honoring and you are being generous towards the guest. وَتُكْرِمُ الْجَارِ, and you are being generous and you are being gentle with your neighbor or the neighbor. He say, and do not be barakallahu fikum la yasdar minka illa khair lijarika, and do not, let not be emanating from you, meaning coming out from you, except good towards your neighbor. Don't let nothing come out from you except good for your neighbor. And likewise he say wa tukfi al-adhaka anhu, and you are refraining and you are stopping yourself from any harm towards them. Also he say fala yasdur minka adha lahu wala li ghayrihi, let it not be coming from you, emanating from you, any harm, whether it is towards your neighbor or towards someone else. طيب, towards your neighbor or towards you. He say min al-nas, you have among the people, man la yasduru minhu illa adha. Subhanallah. He say you have individuals, there is nothing that is coming out of them except evil, except harm. He say you have people, nothing come out of them except harm. Except harm, wal-iyadhu billah. The shahafidhahullahu ta'ala, he say, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ, you have people, مَنْ يَصْدُرُ مِنْهُ أَذَا وَخَيْرُ, you have some of the people that some good things come out of them, but sometimes some evil things come out of them. Sometimes good things come out of them, and sometimes harmful things come out of them. And he say, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ, you have also people, مَنْ لَا يَصْدُرُ مِنْهُ إِلَّا خَيْرُ, that only good things come out of them. So these are the three types of people. Those who know good in them. No good in them whatsoever. You will not hear or see any good in them. You have those. A'adhan Allah minhum. May Allah save us from those. You have the second type. Those who they have good sometime in them. And sometime they have harm and evil in them. Harm and evil in them. And you have the third category without a doubt, which is afdal wa a'la wa awla. They are those who only good come out of them. Only good thing come out of them. Only good come out of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among them. Ameen. فَهَذَا أَعْلَى الطَّبَقَاتِ, that this is the highest level, meaning the third level. Those who on them only good card come out of them. So the Shahafidahullah, he say, بَذْلُ الْخَيْرِ لِلنَّاسِ وَكَفُّ الْأَذَى عَنْهُمْ هُوَ الْإِحْسَانُ لِلنَّاسِ. And this is the summary of what he just said earlier, that bringing forth good to the people and refraining from any harm towards them, he say that this is al-ihsan lin-nas. This is having ihsan, perfection with the people. So if we were asked, what is al-ihsan lil-khalq? That we would say easily these two things. Performing good things towards them and refraining from harming them. And you all remember, barakallahu feekum, the statement that we brought one time of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah in regard to al-husnul khuluq. When he mentioned about al-husnul khuluq, he said al-husnul khuluq is of four things. Right, helping others. Same thing what he's saying. Badlun nada. Badlun nada. Being helpful to others. Ahsant. Sabr ala al-adha. To be patient when somebody harm you. Kafful adha. Refrain from harming anybody. Refraining from harming anybody. Naam, if anybody need help, you help them. That was the meaning of Badlun Nada, being, having, you know, helpful. Last one. Yes, talaqatul wajh. Talaqatul wajh, having a nice, welcoming face. You see your brother, mashallah. I'm sorry? No, talaqat, no. This is. This is general. If you don't know the situation of the person. But if a person, he cuss at the scholars, there is no talaqatul wajh for him. If a person speak bad about the ulama, or making takfir of the King Salman, for instance, we have people like this. There is no talaqatul wajh for them. There is not a welcoming face for this individual. There is no buddy-buddy with those individuals that are speaking bad of the ulama. There is no talaqatul wajh for these criminals whatsoever. So these four things, as Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned, they constitute that which is what? Their husnul khuluq. Tayyib, number one is as-sabr ala al-adha, be patient upon the harm. Meaning, people will harm you, right? And that's normal, barakallahu feek. People will harm you, that's very normal. People will harm you, that's very normal though. If you think you can live a life and nobody gonna harm you, it's impossible. It's impossible. Even between a spouse, between spouses. It's very natural, barakallahu feekum, that you might say something that, you know what I'm saying, your wife don't like. Just like your wife might say something you don't like. Are you going to bring the roof down for one statement? No, man. This is natural and normal. Right? That was right. That's natural. Right? So, but you got to be patient upon those things, barakallahu feek. Number two is that what?
Don't harm nobody.
We already say that.
No, you say people harming, be patient.
That was number one. Right. Barakallahu feek. Don't harm nobody. Refrain from harming others. And I think this is the easy part. Is it the easy part or the more difficult part? More difficult part?
Which one?
Don't harm nobody or be patient upon the harm of the people. Which one is more difficult?
This is difficult.
Which one?
Both of them.
Well, let everybody speak for themselves. That's easier for you. Don't harm nobody, yes. I can understand that for him.
Okay.
He say? Yes. Not to harm anybody, that's easier for him. It's easier for him. Don't harm nobody. Don't harm nobody. It's easier for him. Don't harm nobody. It's easier for him. Patient to on the harm is easier for him. And I can see that in him. Which one do you think is easier on you? Not to harm anybody. Baka? He said no to both of them. Huh? Allah Ustad. You say to be patient? Alhamdulillah. That's the easy one for you, barakallah. So if you look at it, And this is now where everybody got to strive in which one is easier, right? Which one is easier for you? And then, alhamdulillah, you know, try to develop the other one that is, you think is sa'bun alayk, right? Because amma the other two, perhaps it's easy. Aiding people when they need help, right? At-talaqatul wajh, having a welcoming face. Alhamdulillah, I think it's pretty much, those pretty much are easy. That's why when he was mentioning, the first two he mentioned was this issue. Refraining from harming others. That's the first one he mentioned. The second one he mentioned was what? Was as-sabr ala al-adha. To be patient upon the harm. Right? So Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan, hafidhahullah, he mentioned, hafidhahullah, he say, بَذْلُ الْخَيْرِ لِلنَّاسِ وَكَفَّ أَذَا عَنْهُمْ هُوَ الْإِحْسَانُ إِلِّ النَّاسِ هُوَ الْإِحْسَانُ لِلنَّاسِ. He say that bringing or giving yani that which is good to the people and to refrain from any harm towards them, this is the ihsan towards the people, the creation. He say, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And have ihsan, for indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, yani he loves those who have ihsan, those who are the good doer, those who are the good doer. Allah loves those who are the good doer. And this one, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 195. So Rashah Hafidhahullah, he kept going. He said, Hatta al-Baha'im, even the animals. He said, Yajibu an tuhsin ilayhim. It is a must that you have ihsan towards them. He said, Bi an tahi'a ilaha ma tahtaju ilayhi. It is that you are making it available for that which are their needs. You are making it available for the animals what they need. And this is to mean what animal? The one that you have in your backyard. Not the one that you put in a cage or you tie him down. This one you gotta give him or make it available of that which they need. Right? Now this is even barakallahu fikum. He used the word, he said, Hatta al-Baha'im yajibu. It is a must. It is a must that you make it available for that which they need. Right? It is a must. We nobody gonna tell you you have to put some water outside for the birds. It's wajib upon you. No. But if you have a sheep or a goat or a chicken or this or that on your backyard, it is a mandatory for you to be barakallahu fikum making available for them food and drink. To be making it available for food and drink. You all remember these two, and both of them were in relation with animal. One went to the hellfire and one was in the jannah. Excuse me. And all of that bisababi ash, animals. One tied down, a female, a lady tied down what? A cat in a room. Did not feed it. Did not let it go and find the risk of Allah until it died. And he was what? She was what? Placed in the hellfire. But hunaka nuqta. That she was not placed in the hellfire because of shirk. That's why this action was being mentioned. So that also it is to show that she will not be in the hellfire forever. Why? Because what led her in the hellfire was bisababi ash. Because of an animal that she mistreated. Because if it was shirk, then the mistreat of an animal will not be significant compared to shirk. Right? What will be mentioned about the shirk? And she will be in her fire forever. And the other one, that was a prostitute, that barakallahu fikum quenched her thirst and quenched the dog thirst. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her of her sins. هذا يدل. It is a proof, barakallahu fikum, the importance of tawheed. Now she was viewed as the worst of the society. But subhanallah, look, an action quenching the thirst of an animal led her to the what? To have the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That also